The Office of the Prime Minister has decided to create a policy designed specifically for individuals with disabilities and the elderly when it comes to the customer service they receive and ease in accessing the various public services. As such, the Office of the Prime Minister decided to host a two-day workshop aimed at training senior members of various public service sectors on how to go about dealing with disabled and elderly persons. Senior Policy Analyst in the Office of the Prime Minister, Sigma Matthew McCorvis, explained that this new policy falls under a project entitled the Customer Service Enhancement Project.
When it comes to customer service, as it relates to persons with disabilities, this is an area that we really needed to improve. We really need to ensure that persons with disabilities, when they come to receive customer service from the government, that they feel that they're getting the best customer service that they can possibly get. And so we embarked on working on a policy that is going to be designed specifically for persons with disabilities and for the elderly.
She emphasized that a special committee was established to draft the policy, including representatives from the St. Lucia Blind Welfare Association, National Council of and for Persons with Disabilities, and Council of and for the Elderly People. Disabilities rights activist and social impact consultant Jessica Jacoby expressed the hope that participants would leave the workshop more open-minded to the issues of persons with disabilities.
It is expected that they will be able to go to their respective spaces and advocate and change their mindset, as well as to work with their departments and ministries to change not only mindsets but also the environment to ensure that it is more disability friendly. For example, places that do not have accessible washrooms or walkways or parking facilities.
She further stressed that this inclusion extends itself to the digital world and ensuring that the elderly and disabled persons have the facilities and resources necessary to access digital services, as this is a key component of inclusion. St. Lucia Blind Welfare Association Executive Director Anthony Avril noted that the SLBWA has been advocating for a more inclusive society for decades and therefore supports the new policy.
The aim today is to start to ensure that the public service would be more user-friendly for the people living with disabilities. So this is extremely important, and we are hoping that it will send, it is the right signal is being sent right through the society.
Currently, the draft policy is being circulated amongst the committee members and will then be presented to the various government ministries and departments. The training workshop began on Tuesday, 5th December at the Public Service Training Institute in Union. For the DBS News World, Miriam Montout reporting.